Dear Diary, my name is Lucy Bellstaff and I'm 11 years old. I'm writing to you because we're finally going on holiday. We never go on holiday. My dad works so hard that we never usually get to go. Well, he's finally taken some time off and we're going to France. We've borrowed a van from Dad's sister. She lives in France and the steering wheel on Auntie Margaret's van is on the wrong side. Let me introduce you to my family. My mum is Jen. She's gorgeous and I love her. My dad is James and he's always helping people. I have two brothers, Wills and Jake. They are best friends. Wills has a secret box where he keeps all his special things. I don't know where he gets it all from. Mum doesn't know about Wills's box and Jake has made me promise not to tell her. I never break a promise. I like my brothers. They're fun, but they are boys, so they're always up to something. I go to church with Mum and Dad every week. I love church. I can sing as loud as I like there. I had to be in hospital recently. Mum said I needed some tests. I don't know what's wrong. I'm not ill. I have funny turns. I don't even remember them. But it upsets Mum, so I wish it would stop. Anyway, I'm going to tell you all about our holiday, so get ready. Love, Lucy.
Okay, you lot, you can go to the toilet now, but watch out for cars. It's busy out there and they come from the wrong way and everything.
Are you going too, darling?
Yeah, and then I'll get us a coffee and I'll drive the next leg, okay?
I love you.
Come on.
Come on, guys. Time to go.
Mm-hmm. What the...
Jen? Jen! 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 Wait! Jen! What in heaven's name...
What's going on? Call me just as soon as you can. I'll wait here for you. Okay, bye. It's James. Where are you?
Dear God, thank you for keeping us safe today. Please give us strength.
What did Dad say when you phoned him?
He's on his way back to England. Shh, close your eyes. And dear God, thank you for the food we eat and our warm beds where tonight we sleep.
I miss Dad. What did he say? Did you leave him behind on purpose?
Heavens no. It was a mistake. But as it turned out, he had to go back to England anyway. I've spoken to him and he said to say that he loves you all very much. Amen.
Is that what he really said?
Come on, you lot. Time for sleep. We can still have lots of fun before Daddy joins us. Night-night.
Night-night.
Love you.
Love you too.
I guess you're not going to call. I'm going home. I'll make my own way. God, what a mess.
Hey, darling.
I've got it.
You have it?
Yes, it's here.
Get it out.
Out of the country. Absolutely.
Katie, you get that bag out of England and you and I can be together. Forever.
So how long before you join me?
Within the week.
Heaven.
Bye.
Ciao.
Bye.
Bye.
What do you want?
Katie Saunders.
Hello, Kate, it's Jen. How are you?
Look, I know I miss Mum's birthday get-together again.
It's not why I'm calling.
Oh. You all right?
Well,
Dad?
No.
The kids are okay?
Yes, they're good. No, it's James. He's been having an affair.
Where are you?
In Margaret's van in the middle of France somewhere with the kids.
Well, where's he then?
I left him at a service station. Just sort of drove off and left him there.
Exactly whereabouts in France are you?
In the mountains, in the middle.
Listen, I'm coming over. I'll get the next train. Text me the details and I'll join you as soon as I can, okay?
You're coming over?
Send me that text.
My perfect sister. Useful at last.
I'm home, please, Jake. I couldn't find you anywhere.
We're going to have a visitor.
Grandpa Gordon.
Nana Roche.
Auntie Margaret?
No. Auntie Katie.
You invited Auntie Katie? Why? Why would you do that? You hate her.
Oh, it's the truth, Jen. How much further?
I don't hate her, Lucy. That's a terribly strong word.
Right. Taxi.
Bonjour. Oh, no, no. Ah, no, no, no. Got it. No, it's okay.
You guys have hardly spent any time with her, so be nice.
Okay.
Hello, Jen. Hi, guys.
Bought some sweets.
Want some?
We don't eat sweets, Auntie Katie.
What was that film about a village where they all had blue eyes and they could kill you just by looking at you?
Hey, get your grubby hands off my stuff.
Katie's only trying to help.
I don't want any of you kids messing with my bags, okay?
Why don't you guys go off to the playground? Let's try and find somewhere for those bags. So it's true. You and James really have gone all born again.
Do you want some tea?
Coffee?
I made tea.
Sure.
Quite a mess, eh?
Well, considering all the kids, I think it's quite tidy.
I'm in with James.
Oh.
Yeah. Sorry. Thanks for coming, by the way.
No problem.
I know you're quite busy. It's just I...
So have you thought about, you know, what you're going to do?
No. What should I do?
I don't know.
I don't want him back. How's your work?
Fine.
Your boss?
Fine.
You and he still...
Yeah. So did he just tell you? Like that?
He left a message on his phone.
You listen to his messages?
Well, I didn't expect that. I mean, he and I wish...
Look, how lucky is that? You're both Christians. You can forgive each other.
No! I can't, Katie. That's the point.
Oh, come on. There's no need to wail and gnash your teeth. It was just a quick shag, wasn't it? It normally is.
What if he's in love with her?
Well, you lose, I guess. Oh, I'm sure that's not the case. I promised Paul I'd call when I got here. Would you mind if I...
No, go ahead.
You all right, then? Jolly good. Back in a tick.
Are you a bit crying?
No.
Is Auntie Katie leaving?
No, I don't think so.
What a shame.
Hey, gorgeous, it's me. I miss you. Well, I'm in the middle of nowhere. France. I got the train down.
While we're waiting for Dad to join us, we're going to follow the old medieval route
to Santiago de Compostela. We're going on a pilgrimage.
What's a pilgrimage?
It's a journey in search of the truth.
Like a treasure hunt.
Cool.
Actually, I'm with my sister, but she's having a bit of a crisis, so it's not exactly party time, but hey.
What's the treasure?
The truth, Pooh Brains.
Lucy.
Really? How long?
The bones of St. James the Greater.
Bones! Brilliant!
St. James. Like Dad.
Dad's not a saint, is he?
Of course. Me too. Ciao. Party time.
The bones of St. James the Apostle are believed to be buried in the cathedral in Santiago. And every year... Okay. It's all over. It's all over. Let's get her up. Come on, my darling. Up again. Up again, Beth. It's all over. Give us a hand. Let's go. Oh, thank you, Jake. Oh, yeah. Thank you, darling. Let's get her into the van.
What just happened?
She has these visions.
Visions? That's epilepsy.
No, it isn't. She's been tested for that.
She was talking gobbledygook, right?
It's hard to tell. Sometimes we think she speaks in Latin or in Russian.
Oh, this is not right. That is not normal. She needs professional help.
I won't have her put through any more tests. It's just something that happens.
Oh, well, that's all right then.
We're going on a pilgrimage to Santiago in Spain. Maybe this is a sign.
A sign?
If we can just make it to Santiago, I'll know.
Know what? Oh, can't we just go to Costa del Sol and get a suntan?
You coming then?
I just got here. I'll keep you company if you want.
I do appreciate you coming. Really, I do.
Well, if I'm going to join the touring production of Exorcist the musical, I better make myself a cup of coffee.
Just a little one.
Is she gone now?
Who, darling?
Auntie Katie.
No. She's going to come on our pilgrimage with us.
Great.
She is my sister.
But she's horrible.
She's just prickly. She's come all this way. Let's make an effort.
You have the same parents, and you're so kind. She's horrid. How is that possible?
Everyone turns out different. We're all just trying to feel like we belong. So, let's make a real effort so Auntie Katie feels like she belongs.
I miss Dad.
Me too.
It's supposed to be a family holiday. But with Dad, not horrid Auntie Katie.
And I'm supposed to be the Queen of England.
You are the Queen of England. Only younger and much prettier.
And you're the Princess. So, let's be gracious to our subjects, no matter how prickly.
Okay. You did leave Dad behind on purpose, didn't you?
Why do you say that?
Mum! Auntie Katie told Wills to fuck off.
Oh dear, did she? What did he do?
Nothing really. All he did was do a handstand and knock over her tea on her precious bags.
You could just completely change your whole life. This is one of those moments.
I don't want to change. I like my life.
Do you really believe all that Jesus stuff?
It's more James's thing, if I'm being honest. He needs it. I don't. I really thought I knew him. He preaches about this sort of thing. Do you ever think about Paul's wife?
More than he does, probably. But my case is different. They've been living separate lives for years now.
Is that what he tells you?
It's not the same. His wife's a bitch. Your trouble is you're too nice. You let people walk all over you.
Come on, guys. Time for bed. Let's clean those teeth and we'll have a story.
Bloody midwich cuckoos.
I will clear up my own mess. Thank you.
diamonds.
Of course they are.
Caught you, you little thieves. Now, what have we got here?
Now, I won't tell Mom. I have this. Deal?
Okay. All right, Aunt Katie.
She's the laziest person in the world. She never does anything to help. We should play a trick on her.
No, Mum won't like that. We're supposed to be nice to her.
Does she really have to come all the way with us?
I suppose so. She doesn't have any friends of her own.
Come on, let's get this camp packed up. Time to move on. Katie, can you help? Can't you lot ever just chill? It says here, pilgrims get cards stamped. Are you going to do that?
My card's been stamped, thanks.
Speak English.
Hey.
Our van's broken down. Do you know where we can find a mechanic?
Mecánico. Yo soy mecánico.
You're a mechanic? Do you think you could have a look for us?
Sí, por supuesto. Sin ningún problema.
Great.
Un momento.
Sweetheart, keep your hands away from all the bits, both of you. All three of you. Hooray! That's brilliant. You are clever. I must pay you something.
Hola.
Hola, chicos. ¿Querréis tomar algo con tanto calor?
Surely we should be giving you things.
Pilgrims?
No,
sí,
I can't accept that.
Just take it, Katie.
Good day to you, ma'am.
Good day, Elvis.
Well, bless my soul.
Have you been the moon?
Nope. South Africa.
Do you need help?
Well, yes, I do, ma'am, and you'll bang on time.
Everybody, this is Elvis.
Howdy, folks.
He needs help.
Oh, tell us what to do.
Where are you going?
Oh, Santiago de Padilla.
Well, if it helps, we can give you a lift to the next town.
Well, thank you kindly, ma'am.
Come on, then, in the van, it's raining.
Will you sign my poster?
Sure thing, little lady. Well, thank you for the ride.
It's a real pleasure.
You be sure to come to give, okay?
Auntie Katie, Elvis signed my poster.
Friend of yours?
No. No idea who it was.
Where did you get that?
Elvis gave it to me.
I don't believe you.
That was a long day. Early night, I reckon.
Will stole that mouth organ from Elvis.
Will, did you steal it?
No.
Truth?
No, I borrowed it from his bed.
So, lying and stealing. Those are very serious things, William. I don't ever want you to steal. And please, don't lie.
You lied about Dad.
No, I didn't. Yeah. Yes, I did, but that was different. Anyway, this is about stealing. You know better than that. Has Jake been stealing with you?
You stole Grandpa Gordon's roast potatoes right off his plate.
Oh, Jake, that was nothing.
It was mean. Grandpa Gordon loves roast potatoes.
It was for his own good.
You still stole them so that you could eat them all for yourself.
You two are impossible. Just behave yourselves. Come on, bed, all of you.
Always at bedtime. Oh, tell us a bedtime story, Jen.
I know. Tell her the one about the wife who got so pissed off with her husband that she just drove off and left him at the petrol station. Oh, I'm sorry. I'm sorry. Listen, children, you'll be glad to know that I'm leaving tomorrow and you can carry on with your pilgrim thingy and, I just leave you to it.
May I join you? Earlier in front of the children. That was not nice.
Well, they're going to find out sooner or later. What's it matter?
They should have heard it from me first.
Well, I saved you the trouble.
So, you're leaving tomorrow?
Probably. Paul has a couple of things he has to deal with, but once they're settled...
A couple of things? What? Murdering his wife and disposing of the evidence.
He's downsizing the company. He had to let a few of us go.
He fired you?
No, I agreed to go.
But you have no job.
Well, he'll sort me out.
When he gets here?
Yes.
But you have no idea when that will be.
Soon!
phone, okay? Jesus!
What is going on?
Jen, I am just fine and friggin' dandy.
You're the one who's up shit creek without a paddle, which must be a shock to your perfect world.
I'll be on my way tomorrow. You have one less thing to worry about, and your kids can hate somebody else.
They don't hate you. Why do you find them so hard to like?
I just don't like children.
You got pregnant too young, that's why.
What?
Everybody knew.
Oh, well, thank God their eldest daughter was such a freaking saint.
It's always about you, where you were, what you've done. You didn't call, you just disappeared.
You hate me. And you always did.
Don't be so stupid. I never hated you.
Oh, I've ruined everybody's lives, and you don't hate me. And that's crap.
The car from last night?
I don't know.
If it shows up again, I'm going to call the police. I'm beginning to feel a bit vulnerable.
Let's not call the police.
Why? This has got something to do with you. Katie, what's going on?
Paul asked me to look after something for him.
What?
He decided to liquidate some assets, and he asked me to hide it. He's going broke. He'll lose everything.
So that's what's in your precious bags.
It's my business, not yours. It's time I left.
You've been using us. I should have known. And now you've put us in danger. You've put my children in danger. How dare you?
Get your own house in order before you cast the first stone.
Where do you think you're going? No shoes.
Why is Katie leaving?
Did you get it?
Yes.
Gosh, you scared me.
Oh, I'm terribly sorry. I didn't mean to startle you. I was just admiring your sign. Terrific. The way, the truth, and the light.
Hello, Dad? Yes, it's Lucy. Me too. We're in Spain now.
You see, the way is a prism. The light strikes it and shatters into potentially infinitesimal shards of wonder. The truth? That's subjective. Different kettle of fish for each and every one of us. And no one can perceive the beautifully crafted journey of another.
She's fine, but whatever you did made her really angry.
Auntie Katie's with us. I know, weird, huh?
But the light. Now, thankfully, here we come to a concept pure and simple. It is the whole sum of itself and more. A source, a portal. And we all hang from its branches like so many baubles shimmering beneath its omnipresence.
I think my sister may be in danger.
What kind of danger? Real, existential, or imagined?
Does it matter?
I suppose not.
We're following this medieval pilgrim route. St. James the Greater. Yeah, the Apostle. Dunno, somewhere in Spain.
You know this route?
I've been walking it regularly for the past 5 years.
Wow, you must be very devout then.
I wouldn't put it quite like that, but I'd surely be dead without it.
Bye, Dad.
Well?
He sounds all right. He's not cross. He said he's worried about us.
What do you think he did?
I don't know. But whatever it was really bad. We'll just put this back before Mum notices.
Are you going on to the next town? Would you keep an eye on my sister?
Well, of course, dear lady. I tell you what, there's a park in the town. What say we meet up there in a little over 2 hours, and I'll give you a progress report. Well, I'd best not lose sight of my ward if I'm to keep an eye. If you'll excuse me.
I'm sorry, Jen Bellstaff.
Geoffrey Chaucer.
Geoffrey Chaucer?
Sorry, Chandler. Geoffrey Chandler. I get muddled sometimes. Delighted to meet you, dear lady.
No, Katie, don't worry. That's just Geoffrey. I met him on the road and I asked him to keep an eye on you.
When?
After you stormed off.
He just seems a strange bloke after me. He could be a lunatic.
Eccentric, I grant you. Lunatic, no. Actually, he's very charming.
Hello, Geoffrey.
Ah, there you are. I was doing quite a good job. But I think she spotted me. She started zigzagging about. I'm not as nimble as I once was.
You did a wonderful job. Thank you so much, Geoffrey.
Ah, there she is. Jolly good show, old thing. Very resourceful.
What do you do, Geoffrey?
Well, brothers at the monastery send me walking from time to time to help keep me focused.
You live in a monastery?
I do, young lady, I do.
Why?
Because I'm a monk.
Do you like living in a monastery?
Well, I understand life there. I seem to fit in and not cause trouble. So, little people, what do you want to be when you grow up?
An inventor, I think. Definitely not a monk.
I don't know what I want to be.
Well, think of all your good points and then see what fits.
Well, Mum says I'm very caring. Maybe a nurse.
Oh dear.
Mummy, Geoffrey can't breathe.
Breathe into this, Geoffrey. Breathe into this. There, head forward. That's it. That's it. Boys, why don't you head back to the van? Katie, would you take them? That's enough.
Hi, Geoffrey.
That's fine. It must be a little bit of sunstroke, really. I'll be fine.
I wish we could leave Auntie Katie behind and take you instead. She's a non-believer.
Does she believe in herself?
Definitely.
Well, then she's no more a non-believer than I am.
Really? You're a monk and you don't believe?
I believe in lots of things.
Geoffrey, can I ask you something about my dad? I'm worried he'll be sent to hell.
You don't get sent to hell. It's a place you create for yourself.
When you know you've been bad. But my daddy has.
Now that is where the forgiveness comes in.
Mum, he's dead! He's dead!
He's still breathing, Lucy. He's not dead. What happened?
He was just talking and he fell over.
We've got to get him out of the sun.
I'm fine.
Come and rest in our van. How important is it to you to actually walk the whole pilgrim route? Because I'm thinking you may need a few days to recover. And I'm more than happy for you to travel with us for a bit.
I say, recovery in your comforting presence. I don't think I've ever had a better offer.
So you'll join us then?
Thank you. I will. Would anybody object to me taking a nap?
Please do, Geoffrey. Make yourself at home.
Thank you. You're so very kind. My own wife is as cold as the bottom step.
We stopped.
We have a problem, and I want to solve it now. Geoffrey, put a hat on. We don't want another paper bag episode, do we? So, everyone out of the van. Mm. Katie, bring the bag.
Oh, my goodness.
Oh, geez. What a stash. Where did you get it, Auntie Katie?
I was asked to look after it. But I may be changing my mind. This is becoming more trouble than it's worth.
Not much that, maybe.
So, suggestions.
You could give it to me?
I could, Jake, but it's dirty money.
It's quite clean to me.
So where does this money, this energy made manifest, come from? Where hides the devil that conjured it?
Holland Park.
I see.
Greyhound to Vegas. Jen the Pilgrim, I'm all shook up.
It's great to see you, Elvis.
Hey, kids, how you doing?
This is our good friend, Geoffrey. Geoffrey, this is Elvis.
So it is.
Are you the roadie?
Yes. I suppose I am a roadie. Good word. Well, I'm honored to meet you, Elvis.
Any chance of a ride on the mystery machine?
Of course. You turned up at the perfect moment.
Hey, I always do.
My goodness,
This is turning out to be the most delightful and unusual pilgrimage ever, without a doubt.
And Katie, phone the devil in Holland Park and find out what's going on. And be nice. Please?
Well, Auntie Katie be punished for the dirty money?
No, Jake.
Will she go to prison?
No, no, it'll all be fine, I promise. There are four adults here and... Just wondering. Bye.
Can someone rig up a washing line so I can air these damp towels, please? Maybe someone could do the washing up while I try and do it then.
Who would like a big slice of cake and some hot chocolate?
Oh, that'd be nice.
Me, please. Me too.
Oh, that sounds absolutely chocolate. Wonderful.
Then get off your bottoms, rig up the washing line, hang out the towels and sweep out the tent. Now!
Lucy?
Jeffy, can you help me?
Des cœurs noirs, trying chim, chow quan chim, te quai ve. Des cœurs noirs, trying chim, chow quan chim, te quai ve.
Thank you.
she all right now?
Doesn't seem to harm her in any way. I just wish it would stop.
It sounds familiar. Do you mind if I hang on to this?
Of course not. If you can shed any light on this, Geoffrey, I would be most grateful.
Guys, back in the tent. Fast as you can.
What
do you think? The car's back. Listen, I'm just going to take the money and go.
No, no. No, we must all stick together. What can he do if we all stick together?
What if he has a gun?
Shut up about guns. You'll frighten the children.
If he wants the money, I'm just going to give it to him.
Help you?
Yes. I'm looking for someone who has something that belongs to me. And I believe he's with you.
What's his name?
Luke Tipping.
Geoffrey, do you know a Luke Tipping?
No.
Elvis?
Elvis, that's him.
Can I ask your name, please?
Valerie.
Elvis, do you know a Valerie?
Oh, yes, ma'am. She's my personal manager.
Valerie, baby.
And not your baby.
I knew you wouldn't miss my Santiago gig. That's awesome.
I'm not here to see your gig. I'm here to get the jacket.
Were you dumping this Elvis for another?
No, I just want the jacket.
Come on, baby. Don't be cruel. You gotta let me do Santiago in the costume. I beg of you. Elvis ain't Elvis without the costume.
I don't leave until I have the jacket.
Give a guy a break. I'll give it back after the gig. Or look, I'll buy it off you.
Well, it seems quite clear, Valerie. He will give you the jacket.
Chill. What do you make me doesn't buy me at lunch? It's just business. Diamond business.
Diamonds?
Diamonds. Give me the jacket.
Geoffrey.
Yes?
Could I have my jacket, please?
You carried the diamonds out of South Africa. So keep quiet. Hai capito?
Must have fallen quite hard. It's just a bang on the head. I'm fine. There's nothing to do with the cash.
Cash?
I knew diamonds.
I smuggled diamonds, mate.
Oh, but she did have a gun.
She did?
Yeah, balls, I'll give her that.
Will that lady come back?
No. No, it's okay. Everything's fine. Don't worry.
It's okay, kid. She got what she came for.
why people gotta get so mean. She was bare to the bone.
I should have seen that coming. I'm sorry.
But if she knows, why hasn't she told us off?
She's got other things on her mind. But you're right. This is bad. I'll tell you what, give back anything you can, and the rest of it we'll put in the bottom of my bag. And if there's a problem, we'll say it was me, okay?
Okay. Thank you, Auntie Katie.
Mine are the lips that long to kiss you, and the embrace to keep you warm. I am the man who'll always love you and keep you coming home. 'Cause if the Lord had made an angel, he gave her wings and set her free. You are the angel that I prayed for, and you're right here beside me.
That's beautiful. Who wrote that?
Why, I did, ma'am.
Elvis wrote that?
Oh, no, not the real Elvis. I mean, I wrote it.
Luke Tipping.
Yeah, I write a lot of songs.
And perform them?
No, just Elvis stuff, tried to test it. Valerie said my songs weren't good enough to perform.
She's wrong.
She's wrong about a lot of things.
May I?
Sure.
Your beautiful face out of my mind. Your words of wisdom always remind me of the way you make my day, my sweet Lord.
Well, it seems old Elvis got some mean competition.
Well, thank you kindly, sir.
If you come to the gig, you have to get up to sing a bit with me, okay?
Maybe.
What do you mean, if we come to the gig? Try and keep us away. Roll on tomorrow.
We're gonna find the treasure tomorrow? The bones? A skeleton?
I think we found enough skeletons in the cupboard for one pilgrimage.
Did we? One! But I didn't see them!
Not really, Jake. It's just an expression.
Come on, Baker. I'm
going to help you with the dishes. That'd be great, thank you.
Does Mum know about you and James?
No. She's just getting a terrible state. She worships him. And I called you.
I'm glad.
You're getting old, you know?
Yeah, I know.
Did Mum ever meet Paul?
Oh, God, no. I've been thinking. I might buy myself a dog.
Steady. Dogs for life.
Come on, girls. Them bones, them bones, them. Right, bones, them bones, them bones, them. Down, bones, them bones, them. Down, bones, down. Hear the word of the Lord. I said your head bones connected to your back bone. Your back bone connected to another bone. Your shoulder bones connected to your pelvis bone. Now hear the word of the Lord. Stone, babe, just mean the road, you know what I'm saying?
And no eventual destination.
Just my next gig.
Wow. So how do you choose where to go next?
I don't choose, I just keep moving.
Wow.
Wow.
Yes, wow. I'm so sick of never leaving anything to chance. Everything organized 6 months in advance. I'm so sick of the feeling that if I stop, it'll all collapse. I mean, look. I'm here. I'm not fallen into a void or locked in a cupboard somewhere for later use.
Cupboard?
I'm just happy to be right here, right now.
Now you're talking.
I mean, I seriously don't recommend having an affair with a married man.
I'll bear that in mind.
It's just pure...
Adultery?
Well, pain, Geoffrey, pain. If you're a monk, you wouldn't know about pain. Or saving your monastery. Relationship's not even an option.
Actually, I have a PhD in pain. And then I saw it in neon. It said, walk away and don't look back. That was one of my better moves. Valerie is the definitive ice queen.
Yes, that came across.
No, I'm really sorry. Look at you.
Just anybody become a nun?
Well, it helps if you're a female, of a Christian persuasion, and disciplined by nature.
That's my sister. Jen?
Yes?
You could always become a nun.
True.
You see, it was God or the bottle. And the trouble is, I do like to get drunk. Still, the journey's the thing, eh? But then, of course, you know that. You're on a pilgrimage.
Oh, I'm not on a pilgrimage.
All things bright and beautiful. Beautiful. Come on, join me.
All creatures great and small.
Oh dear, I think Geoffrey's drunk.
How can you tell with Geoffrey?
No, no, that's not good.
Well, am I missing something here?
No, I only just met him.
Really?
Yes, really. It's time I made some coffee.
If you have to.
And beautiful, all creatures great and small, all things wise and wonderful, the Lord God made them.
Eureka. Vietnamese, Lucy. See, I thought it was Tibetan to begin with, and that set me off on the wrong track.
So what does it mean? What was I saying?
Have a look. Have you read this book?
Oh yes, it's one of my favourites. The Buddhist philosophy one.
An intellectual sponge. Fascinating.
You're really good at solving stuff, Geoffrey. Could you call my dad and make him say sorry to Mum for whatever he did?
You can't make someone say sorry, Lucy. Free will, thank goodness. Better to pray that the right thing happens at the right time, with the right outcome for all concerned. Have faith in that. There are more things in heaven and earth, Horatio, than are dreamt of in your philosophy. Don't frown and wrinkle up your pretty face. I think your dreams are in very good hands.
How do you know?
Because you have an angel for a mother.
Morning, lovely girl.
Well, fellow rock and roll pilgrims, Vegas is calling. Hey, I'm counting on you, 10 o'clock tonight. Spread the word, people.
Bye, bye.
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 Bye, Lee.
Geoffrey?
Yes?
Is there a poor box in there?
Yes.
Put all this in there for me, would you?
You're not coming in then?
No. I need to make a phone call.
What's this?
Jeffrey worked out what I was saying. It was Vietnamese, Mum. It wasn't nonsense. Always leave the door of the cage open for the return of the bird.
Beautiful Buddhist phrase about the nature of forgiveness. Time, as they say, is the great healer. We don't particularly like the image of gentle erosion, but it is kindness at work. An earthly kindness, inherent in nature. Peace be with you, Jen. If you ever get to heaven, throw me a rope.
Where's Jeffrey?
He's gone. Said he had to see a man about a god.
How'd you feel?
Like a tourist.
I have no job and no relationship. I have nothing.
I'm sorry.
That's a good place to start.
Do anything.
You idiot. You total idiot.
Jen, please.
I'm fine without you. It's good to remember I'm just fine without you. I don't need you.
But I need you.
No, you don't. Or you'd have done things differently.
I can't change anything, but can we just start again? Go somewhere new? Whatever you want.
I've been trying to work out how I really feel about you, knowing you could do this, and...
And?
And I hate you. And I love you. And I hate you. And I love you.
I'll take it. Believe me when I say I'm so ashamed. Jen, I'm begging your forgiveness. You and the kids? You're all I care about. Please.
I don't see how it can ever be the same again.
It can't, I know, but it can be something new.
How will I ever trust you again, James?
Because I know now. I'd rather die than lose you.
Happy holidays, everyone!
Are we on holiday?
Not yet.
I love you.
I know.
I missed anything.
Cheers.
Señoras y señores, escúchame mucho, pero el concierto con Elvis Presley esta noche no es posible. Escúchame, señoras y señores, muchas gracias y mucho aplauso para el concierto del grupo Luke Tipping esta noche.
Hola, buenas noches. Thank you.
Thank you.
Come on! Oh yeah! You can't get to heaven on a pair of skates, 'cause you roll right by the pearly gates. You can't get to heaven on a pair of skis, 'cause you shoot right through St. Peter's knees. And if you ever get to heaven, get a rope and pull me through. And if you ever get to heaven, I'll be right there behind you. And if you ever get to heaven, get a rope and pull me through. And if you ever get to heaven, I'll be right there behind you. I love you, Santiago. Oh yeah. You can't get to heaven in an old Ford car, 'cause the damned old car won't go that far. You can't get to heaven in a limousine, 'cause the Lord don't sell no gasoline. And if you ever get to heaven, get a rope and pull me through. And if you ever get to heaven, I'll be right there behind you. And if you ever get to heaven, get a rope and pull me through. And if you ever get to heaven, I'll be right there behind you.
On powder and paint, 'cause it makes you look like what you ain't.
Everybody, come on, clap your hands. Hey, Lucy, come on up here. Bring your mama, too. That's it, people. Come on, keep it going. Give it up.
And if you ever get to heaven, get a rope and pull me through. And if you ever get to heaven, I'll be right there behind you. And if you ever get to heaven, get a rope and pull me through. And if you ever get to heaven, I'll be right there behind you. And if you ever get to heaven, get a rope and pull me through. And if you ever get to heaven, I'll be right there behind you.
If you ever get to heaven,
oh yeah.
If you ever get to heaven.
If you ever get to heaven, no.
If you ever get to heaven.
If you ever get to heaven.